Hello friends and welcome back. In previous video, we have understood about elastic and plastic deformation. In today's video, we will understand about Hooke's law. So Hooke's law is stated by Robert Hooke in 17th century. So it is also called as empirical law because it is derived based on the observations. So what was the observation did? So let's talk with the example. So let's take about our favorite example, spring example. So here is one spring and there is a force which is applied at the bottom of the spring and it is fixed at the top location. So what will happen if we apply the force? There is a small deformation. So based on the magnitude of the force, this deformation will vary. If the force is more, deformation will also be more. If the force is small, deformation is also small. So what that means, the force and the deformation of a spring are directly proportional or linearly proportional to each other. So in the mathematical formulation, we write it as a force is directly proportional to the deformation. And if we convert that proportionality sign into equal to sign, then we have to add one constant in the equation. So that equation becomes force is equal to K into X, where K is spring constant, or we also call it as a stiffness of a spring because we have taken the springs example. So this law applicable to the all metals, but there is one condition. What is that condition? So within the elastic limit, when material is behaving elastically, in that region only it will obey this Hooke's law. So how we can state this law? Within the elastic limit, applied force is directly proportional to the deformation of a body. So there is a modified version of this law. What is that modification? So here force is directly proportional to this deformation and we will convert it into F is equal to KX. So what is the modified Hooke's law? That is, stress is directly proportional to the strain and there is a constant of a proportionality that is called as a Young's modulus. So in this example we have considered only one dimensional, that means sigma in the X direction, that is applied force direction, is equal to strain in that direction. So stress is equal to epsilon into Young's modulus, so that stress is directly proportional to the strain and proportionality constant is E, that is Young's modulus. Now this is the generalized equation in which we have considered these terms. So if we consider 3D body, there will be a three axis X, Y and Z. So I have taken one example in the X direction. So if you want to write the Hooke's law in the X direction, we can write it like this. Sigma x is equal to ex into epsilon x. So similarly, we can write it in the y direction and the z direction. So here we are considering applied force direction and the strain in the same direction. So this is the modified Hooke's law, that is stress is directly proportional to the strain and where E is the Young's modulus, which is used as a proportionality constant. So this is the basic equation which we use in the FEA, where we will convert all the form of model into this form of a equation. But it is very simple in the one dimensional. So if you consider two dimensional and the three dimensional, there will be a little complexity will start increasing in this equation. But main thing is stress is directly proportional to the strain, that will remains always there. So thank you for watching. please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.